In 1934, Michael King made a trip to visit the Holy Land. King was then the pastor of Ebenezer Baptist Church in Atlanta. As part of his Holy Land trip, he added a leg to his trip so he could visit Berlin to attend the Baptist World Alliance Convention. One of the talks at the convention was about Martin Luther, the Protestant reformer of the 16th century. King was so inspired and captivated by the way Luther took on the religious establishment of his day. It ignited King's passion for the civil rights movement that was unfolding in the United States. Upon returning to the U.S., King decided to honor Luther's courage and legacy by changing his own name from Michael King to Martin Luther King. At the time, the senior, Martin Luther King, had a 5-year-old son who bore his namesake. For the rest of his life, friends and family would call him Mike, but the rest of the world came to know him as Martin Luther King Jr. This time each year, there is renewed interest about who Martin Luther King Jr. was as a pastor, a husband, father, professor, leader, and revolutionary. King is either painted as a figure who was perfect in every way or as a man who was not nearly as good a man as some wanted to make him out to be. And I think the truth of Martin, like most of us, lies somewhere in between the opinions of those in our life who adore us and those who despise us. A wise person once reminded me to be suspicious of those who applaud you for everything as much as you are suspicious of those who think you can do nothing right. In other words, those who love you don't love you nearly as much as you think they do, and those who hate you don't hate you nearly as much as you think they do either. The point I want to make is that there is a danger in, on the one hand, deifying Martin because he was far from perfect. Conversely, there is a danger in demonizing him because what he accomplished was extraordinary. Those who deify him have a tendency to think no one can do what Martin did, which makes us feel like we can do nothing in the way of lifting others up if we can't change the face of a nation like King did. If we demonize him for all of his moral failings, then we are more prone to think a broken person has nothing to offer this world. More precisely, we, being broken ourselves, also have nothing to offer anyone. The truth, as in all things, is always much more complicated than either of these polarities of deification on the one hand and demonization on the other. Like Martin, we need not be perfect to do extraordinary things. And before you check out on the word extraordinary, don't forget that that's a relative term. For some people, just getting out of bed each and every morning is extraordinary. For someone else, extraordinary is organizing a food drive or planning a protest or trying to keep your kids logged in for school 5 days a week or changing out of your pajamas into actual work clothes. Martin reminds us that you don't have to be perfect to make a difference. He wasn't. Neither are you and neither am I. But he also reminds us that the things that are broken in us also don't have to be allowed to define us. Martin didn't lead a movement that would change the world forever in spite of his brokenness and moral failings. He led a movement out of that brokenness. So on this day of remembering Martin and his legacy, let us not devolve into the cynicism of honoring only those who are perfect. And let us guard against the kind of thinking that leads us into thinking that if we can't be the next Martin Luther King Jr., then we shouldn't be the next anything. Because the truth of the matter is that God and the world doesn't need another Martin Luther King Jr., or a Harriet Tubman for that matter, or a Sojourner Truth, or Rosa Parks, or Malcolm X, or Nanny Burrows, or Bayard Rustin, or Polly Murray, or Ella Baker, or Claudette Colvin. God needs you. Needs you right where you are, doing the things that make for justice and equality and mercy right where you are at now. You're not perfect. I'm not perfect. God doesn't require perfection. God requires open hearts and hands and minds. At every turn throughout Scripture, God didn't call the qualified. In fact, God qualified the called. God is calling. May we pick up the phone like so many before us and answer the call like Samuel, "Speak, Lord, for your servant is listening." Or like Isaiah, "Here I am, Lord, send me." In the words of the late Howard Thurman, born November 18, 1899, and died on April 10, 1981, a mentor to Martin Luther King Jr., who wrote, "Don't ask what the world needs. Ask what makes you come alive and go do it. Because what the world needs is people who have come alive. There is something in every one of you that waits and listens for the sound of the genuine in yourself. It is the only true guide you will ever have. And if you cannot hear it, you will all of your life spend your days on the ends of strings that somebody else pulls. During times of war, hatred becomes quite respectable, even though it has to masquerade often under the guise of patriotism. It's very easy to sit in judgment upon the behavior of others, but it's often difficult to realize that every judgment is, in fact, a self-judgment. Often to be free means the ability to deal with the realities of one's own situation so as not to be overcome by them. And this is the strangest of all paradoxes of the human adventure. We live inside all experience, but we are permitted to bear witness only to the outside. Such is the riddle of life and the story of the passing of our days. There must be always remaining in every life some place for the singing of angels, some place for that which in itself is breathless and beautiful. Lord, open unto me. Open unto me light for my darkness. Open unto me courage for my fear. Open unto me hope for my despair. Open unto me peace for my turmoil. Open unto me joy for my sorrow. Open unto me the strength for my weakness. Open unto me wisdom for my confusion. Open unto me forgiveness for my sins. Open unto me love for my hates. Open unto me thyself for myself. Lord, Lord, open unto me."